CBC here with Paper Reviews. Just had that most gut-wrenching moment when you turn up at the end of the queue and something's gone. So unfortunately, we did manage to get hands on Mexican cake by Westbrook. It was Asian tequila bar as well. That's cool. Got their double IPA instead, which is still another one on my list, and I was really, really, really wanting to try that. So I'm glad they got that. Shane's double IPA, that's cool. We've also got another myth from the legend, that is Hunapu's Imperial Stout by Cigar City as well, which should be quite good. I've tried that one with, again, Matt from the Hop Studio, the man who can always get crazy beers. So Shane's double IPA cooks in 9.2, I believe, and looks much like this. It's a nice, hazy, sort of apricot coloured beer with a nice little bit of white element to it as well. On the nose. Oh, it smells a lot sweeter than I thought it might do. There's a lot of kind of crystal white in there, like sweet, caramelly overtone. Alongside some sweet oranges, apricots, that sort of thing. I think sweet, juicy fruits, you're not too far off. Almost smells kind of candy. Cheers, it's good to try. It's got a really quite intense malty flavour, almost as if it's just like pure wort. It's quite sweet as well at the beginning. You get a real taste of nutty pale malt and this kind of crystal malt alongside it. And then you get like a little bit of dankness from the hops and this sweet orange end as well. It's in my opinion, it's a little bit too sweet for a double IPA. You get a lot of malt character, not a huge amount of hops. But it's got a little bit of dankness to it as well. And it's certainly drinkable. It goes down very smoothly for a big double IPA. It's pretty tasty. So, and next up we've got good old Hunapu by Cigar City from Tampa, Florida. Pours pitch black with that nice kind of coloration on the head again. We've had loads of beers with that lovely kind of coffee colour coloration. On the nose for this. Unsurprising for a beer with like cocoa nibs and cinnamon and different kind of Aztec spices. It has a really huge hit of chocolate. So much chocolate on the nose. Massive amounts of cinnamon too. It's so unusual to smell. It smells like kind of like mole, you know, the Mexican cooking mole, like turkey mole, that sort of thing, not guacamole. Really intense and rich. So cheers, let's go try it. Yeah. I remember when I had it from bottles, I was absolutely blown away about how good it is. Undrafted, it's exactly the same, you know, it's so thick and rich, delicious. It has an extra kind of concentrate flavour that you get from these kind of stonky ones, like Light Lager Dark Lord, to keep harkening back to it. A nice concentrate flavour, big punch in the hair, you get loads of cinnamon, you get loads of chocolate. It's unbelievable how much chocolate's really in it, and this nice kind of spicy, chibi finish. Because I believe it's also got chilies in it too, if I'm totally right. And you get a nice little kind of burn actually, it heats up quite a lot in the aftertaste. But it's just thick and rich, it's got a good reputation, and again, unfortunately, it's a really rare release, and again, it's brilliant. I'm sorry, if you want one, you'll really have to try and find one, it's difficult to find this, but yeah, it's kind of worth the hype, I'm afraid. So, the Shane's Double IPA, yeah, it's pretty good, it's alright. I've had a lot better double IPAs in my time, so it's kind of an okay one, I'm afraid, from Westbrook. But the Hunapu is easy double thumbs up. It's crazy flavours, really well made, points of beer, perfectly balanced, nice and big and rich and sweet. There's cinnamon, there's chocolate, there's chili, almost put the way then. Fantastic beer, really worth your time if you do get to find it. So there you go. Please like, favourite, comment, and subscribe for here at Paper Reviews at CBC. Cheers.